Inside the 30. Brady to his old reliable Edelman, and the Patriots have a first down.
Coming to you.
First and 10 at the 26-yard line.
53 lead now.
54.
But he hit.
On first down, Brady. He hits his target. Left side, Watson. A gain of 6 there on first. And he has now hit number 500. Charles, that is his 500th NFL career catch.
Definitely worthy of applause, but I remember when 500 meant you were going to the Hall of Fame. Nowadays, in today's football, 500 puts you on the path. A significant number.
To throw again on second down, Brady. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Snags it for the pick.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. We've seen both of these offenses still sort of in that figuring things out phase, but I suspect some action on the scoreboard soon as they start out here first and 10. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
First down, Jets.
That's where Crowder makes his hay, in the slot. Jets hoping to see more of that going forward. He signed with him in March after the last four seasons being in Washington. Had three pretty good years and sort of tailed off last season due in large part to an ankle injury. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Another scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. 8 yards on the ground there, and now they're looking at a third and two. Getting the sense, Charles, are going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
They'll try and run for it with Bell. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
It's a gain of 6.
But he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral, also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. No score after one on EA Sports. The Jets with the football here to start the second quarter as they've got it with a first and 10. First downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. From the shotgun, it's a give to Bell. And he'll take it across the 50 and into New England territory. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5.
We got 3. We got 3.
Now Bell. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Give the tackle there to Keon Crossan. I think you mentioned in the opening drive that these guys needed to establish the run, protect the young QB. Actually wrote that down, believe it or not. So how would you assess things so far?
I'm kind of touched that you actually wrote something like that down. I appreciate that, partner. But I do think they've been able to do that. Maybe not as effectively as they've wanted to, but I think we'll see more of as this game goes along because they want to continue to take care of that young QB.
This is third and 1. Very likely 4 down territory, even if they don't get it, though. Here's Bell. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4-down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. And they'll try the air now with Darnold. Oh, he can't hang on. That was a dream chance for any D lineman to possibly get a pick. But instead, it falls down incomplete. Here's second and 10 now from the 35. Now a draw play. This is Bell. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 12 yards there and a first down.
But they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot and picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. Darnold off the play fake to Bell. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Bell. Call it a gain of 3, and it'll be second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Looking to throw again on second down. Darnold. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. Oh, very close to a turnover there in the end zone. Back of the end zone. Could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete. They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. Darnold from the gun. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. That one good for 7 as this long drive continues and the chains move again. Now a first down carry by Bell. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call them, run fits, everyone was in the right place.
On 2nd and 9, Darnold under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Kyle Van Noy coming in hard there on the blitz, and he gets him 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Here's Darnold. His throw caught right around the 6. And they'll rally and stop him short of the first down at about the 6. It'll be a gain of 12, but it will also lead to 4th down. So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And Catanzaro's kick is right through. And the Jets hit the board first. It's 3-0. That drive just seemed to go for an eternity. I could kind of hear our sponsor saying, hey, we need to get our product pushed here. But then it ends in a field goal.
Yeah, how about that? Not enough time for product placement, but plenty of time to get 3 points out of the deal. I know that the guys on defense, though, they wanted to get those products out there. They wanted to stop that drive, just weren't able to do so.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first 2 drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it into the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Let's go, defense. And here we go.
On second down, they'll run with White. Now White lost the football. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Mike 57.
So don't say nothing. Hey, Delta.
57 is the mic. Mike 57.
Hey, 166.
Brady looking to throw on 3rd and 2. A minute 55 left to go in the first half of play. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
It'll be a 39-yard punt, 4 on the return. And the Jets will take over 1st and 10. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. It's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
That's good for 28 yards. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33.
51 to Mike.
And they'll keep it on the ground with Bell. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. John Simon in on the stop. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game, because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Now a 2nd down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
The Jets on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Play action. It's Darnold. Oh, he's going to go for it all. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
A lot of contact there, but there was no way it appeared that he was going to get a flag on that one. Looking for it, but he wasn't going to get it. And as an ex-defensive back, you love it when they let you play and jostle downfield.
And contact defensively. And that might make things 5 yards easier. On 4th down, the Jets turning to Chandler Catanzaro for the field goal try. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And they're able to double their lead just before half. It's 6-0. Still a little bit of time left here in the 2nd quarter, but they do get 3 before the half and expand that lead.
And they have to be happy about that, and we haven't met a team yet that doesn't put an emphasis on trying to get points on the board in the last 2 minutes of a half. They'll be real excited to have those up on the board.
New England with a first down as they begin the drive. Time here for likely a couple plays if they want it, but with the field position what it is, maybe better suited to just sit on this one?
I'm with you totally. I would sit on it and get into the locker room and start over. But if they do decide to try and make a play, we know what the basics are. You run draw, you run screen. I would maybe run a little swing pass and try and get my lineman out in space and see if they can chop a hole into the secondary and see if he can run a little bit.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Here's Brady. He's going to air it out for Dorsett. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go. Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
Watch left, watch left, watch left. He's done with it, he's done right there.
You got three down.
He's got the first down and more past midfield. And he'll take this down to the 40-yard line. So a couple of field goals, that's all we've been able to muster through two quarters of play. 6-0 is our count at the break. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
And they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. They stay on the ground this time. It's Williams. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be 3rd and 3 now.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Crunch time, defense.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Michelle. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. That's good for 9 yards as they convert on the third down play.
Alabama, 380.
I don't think you got it, sir.
Sugar.
Play action. Now it's Brady. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Tremaine Johnson could not be contained on the corner blitz. And their inaugural sack of the game coming from an unlikely source.
You mean it wasn't a linebacker? It wasn't a defensive end?
It was somebody like you.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, that's a surprise for the offense. That's not what they normally get when they think about pressure.
Now this one from about 2 counties over after the sack. They come up on a 2nd and very long. Brady going to throw. Throw left side, complete. It's Cannon.
I'm guessing, partner, that if we're in the huddle with the Patriots right now, there's not a single guy that thinks they have any chance of coming back in this one, especially not with Tom Brady.
Yeah, who's Tom Brady? What's he done in the past as far as comebacks are concerned? Yeah, down right now, but that can evaporate quickly with him in the huddle.
Wait, set, ready?
On 3rd and long, it's Brady. And now a fumble. Brady loses the football.
A play plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
We'll call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And that will come the offense as they take over. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense, we got the lead. Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
This is Bell. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage, but you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
Looking to throw on second down. Darnold, this one caught by Crowder. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. The last catch did get three, but they're still left needing 7 yards on third down. Bell, and he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
Partner, I know my grade school teachers never would believe this, but I can absorb a lesson. I think there's a lesson in this one. He's having a great day running the football, but occasionally, they're going to find a way to stop you, aren't they?
Yeah, this time the defense stepped up in what's been so far a tough game for them.
You rarely call your punter a weapon, but he certainly was there. How about that? Pinning him down at the 1 yard line and helping out the defense in a big way. I'm telling you what, if I'm a defensive coordinator, I might be thinking safety right now.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
That'll go for a gain of 13, helping big time to get away from that end zone. First down. So a little more space to work with here from the 13. On first and 10. They'll run out of the gun here. Williams. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 12-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Another example of just a dominant performance by this defense.
Yeah, you hear all the time about teams that try to steal signals from the other side and try and learn their signs and their tendencies. It's almost like they got the answers to the exam the night before and were well prepared for this final.
Hey, 20, 57.
Watch the screen, watch the screen, watch the screen.
On second and 11 now. Brady, he completes it right side of the lane. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. With James White, you know that he can catch the football. He was third in the NFL amongst running backs last year with 87 catches. And as we've seen, sometimes they come in bunches. Super Bowl 51, he had 14 grabs, including the winning score. Last year in the divisional round versus the Chargers, 15 receptions for White. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. Here's Ryan Allen now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. Now it's Crowder. So a change of possession here on the punt. By the way, they're into the second half now in Philadelphia on the NFL scoreboard. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. Darnold. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 37, and he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10. They'll start the drive with a give to White. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Following the penalty, Michelle. Pro Bowler C.J. Mosley, the Ravens' leading tackler last year, up to make the stop.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
On second down, it's White. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. The 25-yard line is what they need here. This is third down.
57 to Mike. 57 to Mike.
Hey, Foxtrot, Foxtrot.
Check Mike 57.
Now a play fake. Brady. Left side, it's Dorsett. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. He got out of bounds. That's a good thing, but still short of the first.
And now, since this brings up fourth down, the defensive play caller, grab your nerves, because now you don't want to be so amped up that you give them a first down by getting out of your lane.
Oh, no, he lost the football. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. And they're going to hold serve. The defense stops him.
He doesn't get many opportunities to carry it, so he's got to maximize. In this case, after dropping it like that, I think his number's going to go way down. What do you think?
Yeah, and sometimes those fullbacks, let's just be frank, they usually don't have the hands that the running back does.
And it's hard for them because they do so much blocking that a lot of times their hands actually get beat up in the process, and it's hard for them to hold on to the football.
Here's a run on first down that won't even get back to the line of scrimmage. He will lose a yard, second and 11. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play. That'll bring up second down. Tom Brady needing a fourth quarter comeback here. He's actually only done it 8 times in the last 5 years, but if you break that down further, the Pats in those years rarely losing in the fourth quarter like they are now. Now this one to his running back out of the backfield, and he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. The last catch nearly got him a first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert on third and inches. Brady gives to Michelle, and he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. Officially a gain of just a yard there, but they do convert on third and inches. First down, here's White, and he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is a well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
They'll try to pick this up on the ground with White. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1. The gain of five that time gives him the conversion and makes it first and goal. They come up on a first and goal in most likely four down territory as they need a touchdown and the PAT for the lead. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down.
Oh yeah, good surge defensively. Sometimes you can just tell by the way a quarterback lines his feet up behind center. He's going to try and sneak it in, and they catch him here and stop him for no gain.
They'll run it with Williams. And he is in. Touchdown. As his guys are an extra point away now from taking the lead here in the fourth. And his kick is good, but flags come in. Looks like we're going to get a roughing call here on the follow through. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Airing one out for Crowder. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line.
Brandon, offensively, this has been a tough day for them. Trying to find a place to throw the football, it's been extremely difficult. I've got to give a lot of credit to the secondary, especially the corners who've had the receivers on lockdown.
Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Yeah, they're going to try to eat some clock with Michelle. Able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for four-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Now, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it. And let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there.
Wait, that's wide, 80.
Watch the run, watch the run.
Alert!
Brady now on first down. This is White on the screen. Only three there on the screen. It's second down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
Oh, no, he lost the football. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line.
Well, partner, here's where team football gets tested a little bit, because I know the defensive guys were over there chilling on the sidelines, and all of a sudden, they heard the sudden change call, because that fumble puts them right back on the field, and they've got to go out and finish the game now themselves.
Absolutely. Nursing that slim lead here in the fourth, a costly turnover. Less than 2 minutes to play. Down to the wire we go in a one-point game. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. They'll run on first down. Bell. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. That's good for a Jet first down, a gain of 13.
Pardon, you gotta like what they're doing right there. Little by little, they're getting closer. Another good pickup.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They'll run it with Bell. And only able to get two here, stopped at the 30. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. On second down, it's Bell. Might have gotten this one down to the 28, and that's all. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. The give is to Bell. And he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. The Patriots will take their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Catanzaro's kick is good. And with a little over a minute to play, they have taken the lead.
Score too soon? Post-game will tell us, right? Depending on what happens on this drive, that's how we'll analyze it. If the other team scores, they scored too soon. If they somehow hold on, they've managed the clock exactly right.
New England with a first down as they begin the drive. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. Now this time he'll look to throw. A quick throw, but incomplete. He was looking for Edelman there, and it's third down.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle. Got to totally command it, make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
And able to find Dorsett. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. A gain of 19 and picking up the first. And he did exactly what they needed him to do, Charles. Got out of bounds. They had no timeouts.
And they knew that before the play even began. Still executed it. How many times have we seen it happen where you know it, yet a guy's still looking for a timeout or trying to stay in bounds? He got it done.
Caught on the right side by Dorsett. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Hey, check it.
Back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10.
Go Bandit! Help him!
He'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Jordan Jenkins in there to make the save.